tell you, what a week you have had with a premiere in London and everything.
It's true, it's true.
How did you enjoy sitting there with all those people watching yourself on the screen?
Well, I was kind of thrown into it because I was playing with my friend. My little cousins were there, so I was playing with them. And they said, oh, well, you've only got 20 minutes to get ready. So I kind of had to rush off to my hotel room and get ready and ready and ready and put all my clothes on and stuff. And I was thrown into this white Merc and drove off, and all of a sudden I get out of this car and all these rah! Big massive screams all over the place. Loads of flashing all over the place.
All the photographers going, Jamie, yeah, Jamie, Jamie, this
Jamie,
way,
Jamie.
This way.
You can't do anything. But it was really weird. It was really mad. It was crazy.
It's a strange feeling, I guess. And who did you have there that maybe you were in awe of?
Hugh Grant, Johnny Lee Miller, Kathy Burke, people like that, yeah.
Did you get a chance to talk to some of them?
I did, yeah. I got a chance to talk to most of them, yeah.
I suppose they were all queuing up to talk to you.
They were, yeah. They all congratulated me.
Jolly nice feeling, I should think.
Yeah, it was, yeah.
Now, clearly, this film is all about a young boy, as I mentioned, who wants to be a dancer. And this mirrors your life, because what age did you start to dance?
I started dancing when I was six.
Because you wanted to, or because your mum wanted
well,
to?
Because dancing had been in my family for ages, because my mum and my auntie and my sister danced. So when I was very little, I used to get dragged with my sister to the dancing school and competitions and things like that. And I just saw this girl dancing on the stage, and she wasn't doing it properly. She was out of beat and out of rhythm and stuff. And I kind of turned to my mum and said, well, I can do better than that. And she said, well, fine, I'll buy you a pair of tap shoes, you can go on Saturday.
You're on.
I know, it's true, yeah. So it was really my
So family. Have you done tap and ballet and
yeah,
all the
yeah,
rest
yeah,
of
yeah.
it?
Yeah, tap first and then ballet eventually, yeah.
What did your mates say at school when you told them you were taking up dance?
I got a bit of hassle when I was eight. Yeah, they kind of said ballerina boy, tutu girl, things like that. And it's hard for an eight-year-old boy on his own to kind of handle that, because he can't really tell his mum because he'll just get it twice as worse. but eventually I kind of plucked up the courage and kind of thought, it's more of a challenge for me, because I'm going to prove to them that it's not just for girls, it's for boys as well.
And of course, when you go back to school on Monday, I mean, everybody at school, they've had a special preview at their school.
They have.
So they'll all have seen it.
They will have, so I'll have to get all the reactions, and they'll probably say I've changed. that's what they'll say.
Now that you're a star.
Yes, yes, yes.
Actually, were they impressed when they heard that you'd got the part?
Well, they actually got told when I was actually doing rehearsals, so I didn't know what their reactions were again.
Oh, I see, so it's all going to be fresh to you when you go back.
Yeah, I'll go back and they'll have seen it, they'll have heard about it, and seen the reviews.
I adore Julie Walters.
She is, she's great.
So how did you find her to work with?
Oh, she's great. I thought, when they first said you're working with Julie Walters, I thought she was going to be sunglasses, star-studded, always in a trailer all the time and standing in the corner on her own and stuff. But she isn't. She's, like, really real, and she's really down to earth, and she's funny all the time. We had a great time. She was
great. Did she work you hard during all the rehearsals?
Not really, no.
There's quite a bit of dancing, isn't
there? There is, yeah. It's very hard for us both. There was actually a two-month rehearsal period before we actually started shooting, where me and Julie learnt the dances.
Fantastic. At the point of interest, how did you get the part? Did you have to audition a lot?
Seven auditions, uh-huh.
Seven?
Yeah, I went to the first two and I didn't hear anything for 2 months, so I kind of thought, oh, I haven't got the part. But then eventually the casting director phoned me up and said that they're still holding open auditions for Billy Elliott. So I went to about another five. The last audition lasted for about 2 weeks.
And then the last audition lasted for 2 weeks?
Yeah, it was just they were kind of grading how far I got on with my dancing and my standard and things. And then eventually Stephen, the director, phoned me up and said that he'd like me to play the part.
But I hear it, like, was out of thousands of people, thousands 2, of boys.
2,000 boys, uh-huh. Yeah.
2,000 boys. That must have made you feel good when you got the part.
Well, I was watching the football at the time. So I was more into football than what Stephen had to say.
Oh, so tell me about it then. So you get the phone call and you're like, Mr. Cool.
Well, because it was a penalty, it was a 1980s match, right? It was a classic old game, Middlesbrough and Sunderland. so kind of, I'm on the phone and I'm saying, yeah, and I'm just, there's a penalty kick. So I'm kind of like, yeah, go on, son. Yeah, go on, son. And of course he scores, so I'm like, yes, cheers. And he kind of passes the phone over to my mum and he actually said, you would never have guessed I've just offered him a part in a film, would you? And I've said no.
And has your mum been with you throughout all the filming sequence?
Yeah, she was on set all the time. She's been travelling around with me when we've been to America and things like that, so she's getting to travel a lot.
And I wanted to get her to come on the programme today, but she wouldn't come.
No, she's a bit shy,
She said she's happy and proud but exhausted.
She is, yeah, we had a long night last night. Yeah.
And well, listen, when you went to America, this limo treatment, give me the scene as to how they treated you over there.
We arrived in JFK Airport in New York, and all of a sudden this big, massive black limo pulls up, and we kind of go, that's not ours, and we're just expecting a little yellow cab. but no, of course, this big, massive black limo turns up, and they say, well, this is for you. So we kind of go, oh, so we get in this big, massive thing, and we're, like, really surprised and stuff. And we get dragged everywhere in it, though. I mean, not just in one city, everywhere. We went to Chicago, San Francisco, LA, all in limos.
And people looking to see who's this.
Exactly, yeah. And it kind of gives away the kind of feel when a little boy pops his head out with a video camera and starts looking around the place.
Because, wow, I'm in New York.
Yeah, no, because it was my first time.
Yeah, so you went to San Francisco.
I did, Los Angeles. Yeah.
How many weeks or months were you there?
It was about 3 weeks in all. Yeah.
How exciting,
though. It was great.
I mean, do you think it's a bit of dreamland at the moment, you know, that it's all happened so quickly in a way?
Well, it has happened quickly, yeah. But I've been taking an awful lot of time off school, which is a bad thing as well. I'm straight back to school, as you say, on Monday. I've got my GCSEs starting, so I'm not looking forward to them. But it has been great. They've treated me very well.
Do you think you'll be able to settle back down to schoolwork now?
Probably not.
It's going to be hard, isn't it?
It is, after last night, yeah.
You must be sleeping with your reviews, because the reviews have been stunning.
They have. Uh-huh. We've got, like, nearly every television thing, every television clip, every press kit, yeah.